Our Empyrean diffractometer ranges from room temperature to 1200 degrees Celsius in air, vacuum, or inert gas environments, while our Huber diffractometer ranges from 10 Kelvin to room temperature in a vacuum environment. In this experiment, the temperature was increased to a desired value, and the sample was allowed to reach equilibrium before the data were collected. The first item to note is that we see a new peak appear just below 40 degrees 2 theta in the pattern collected at 300 degrees Celsius. Using the full diffraction pattern, the user was able to determine the identity of this phase. More experiments could be carried out to better determine at which temperature it first appears. Looking at the peaks around 38.7 degrees 2 theta, we can see that as the temperature increases, the position of the peak shifts to lower 2 theta, indicating an expansion of the lattice parameters. From these data, we can determine the values of the lattice parameters as a function of temperature, and therefore determine the thermal expansion. This example of a similar experiment on a zirconium oxide sample shows the power of X-ray diffraction in the determination of anisotropic thermal expansion, or thermal expansion that is different for different directions. We can see that the peaks for the 002 and 200 planes shift to lower angles with increasing temperature, while the 020 peak remains relatively unchanged. In a single series of experiments, values for each lattice parameter can be determined for each temperature. If you would like more information about the JIAM diffraction facility or have any questions, here is the address for our website and my email address. Thank you for watching.